So we are back here at the Ram section, taking a look again at not just the frame chassis setup, because it's pretty much an all new setup to be able to support the 35,000 pound maximum gooseneck towing and 30,000 pound maximum fifth wheel towing. But this specific dually truck has some really great characteristics inside of it. And I will show you the interior of this. I think we might have a journalist in here.
Oh, hey.
Hey, are you a journalist?
This is journalist only.
I
have a badge to prove it.
Hey, you have that YouTube channel, Brian's Appliance Repair.
Yes, we talk about how to fix your kitchen and DIY stuff.
What's the DIY stuff?
That's him. He does the DIY stuff.
DIY, yep, that's all me.
Sounds good, guys. Anyways, you probably know by now, this is Brian. He is with Brian's Lawn Maintenance.
You got it, brother.
He is the guy that runs the channel that talks all about the equipment that everyone dreams of having to use personally but can't afford unless they're a commercial outfit.
That's fair. Lawnmowers. Big,
pretty much it, right?
Lawnmowers.
Yeah, yeah. So okay. If I go to Lowe's and I pick up, like, I don't know, whatever brand they have at Lowe's, you're going to look at it and say, yeah, that's really nice. Then you leave laughing at me.
I go, what is this, amateur hour?
No, yeah, exactly.
We talk about how to help you guys grow a more successful lawn care landscaping business.
And you do a really good job of it.
Thanks, brother. I appreciate it.
I refer a lot of people to your channel.
Thank you. Well, I watch your truck channel to learn how to buy my truck, right? My F-250.
And I will continue to try to stop you as you divert the conversation to your friend here.
He wants to buy a Chevy. We're trying to get him.
I was looking at the Chevy.
No Chevys.
Nothing wrong with Chevy, man.
Chevy
makes a good truck.
Chevy, Ford, they're all good trucks.
They're absolutely all good trucks. You can't go wrong anymore. So you are sitting in the 2019, not sure why it's not a 2020, but a 2019 Ram Laramie 3500 dually pickup truck.
Nice. We're just talking about the quality of the leather and the interior. It's actually really nice. I've never really been in any Rams, honestly.
You've been missing out.
I guess.
Especially with the new 2019 models.
Look at this touchscreen display. What is this, like their 12.1 screen?
12-inch screen. 12-inch screen.
It almost looks like the Tesla, you know?
It does, yep. Mm-hmm.
But what you're going to start noticing is a lot of manufacturers going to that. And I feel like I'm leaving out people in the back of the truck. So.
Uh-oh. We have another guest, special guest.
Hey, how you guys doing?
And what was your name?
I'm Michael from Bedell Property Management.
Is that the name of your YouTube channel?
I'm also known as the Debt-Free Landscaper.
There you go.
Good deal. And I will put their channel descriptions in this video, so if you want to support them and do the right thing.
We have a small segment I do on my channel called Truck Talk Tuesday. And so we're here to shoot a bunch of video on all the new trucks and all the new stuff that's coming out at the NIUS. And we're here with JD, which just kind of coincidentally lined up, but this is pretty fun. And talking about trucks, baby.
It's gonna be a good time.
You know, we said that though, but we both announced on our channel that we would be meeting each other. So
it's true.
So this is planned. This is planned, just not too planned. Like, he had no idea what I look like.
What wasn't planned is me arriving 4 hours late.
That's true.
when you're making YouTube videos, the important thing to bring with you is your camera. And I forgot my camera, and I live an hour away.
So that's not an amateur thing.
But you guys can tell I'm blonde, so the roots go deep. So we need to hit the subscribe button so we can, get rich one day, I guess, because we're going to need a huge 401k. Because we're sharp as a tack. So
taking a look at this truck, Ram just released the numbers on it this morning, actually, and they repeated it here. 1,000 pound-feet of torque, 35,000 pound maximum tow capability if you're doing a gooseneck on a 3-inch gooseneck ball. Okay. So if you're used to gooseneck balls, most of them are significantly smaller,
sure.
2 5/16 inch. This is just a massive setup, right?
This is a huge truck.
This it really is.
The dually setup?
Yep.
This is unnecessary for me.
It's
these
custom.
Guys.
Yet.
These guys, maybe.
Yeah,
they do
right?
More landscaping, but this is a huge truck. This is nice.
So here's the question for you, though.
Right.
Do you have to reevaluate your stance on a huge truck like this when all of a sudden you have $2 million revenue coming in every year from lawn care landscape?
No, I'd buy this as a foreman truck or an owner truck.
Yep, and that's the key. You look at a truck like this, when you're working out of your vehicle, a lot of people say, well, I want a base model stripped down truck.
Right.
That's fun to talk about, and it's fun to equip your fleet with if they're
sure.
just going to be battered every day.
Sure.
But people who want to grow their business and they want to have a vehicle they're comfortable with being in for hours and hours and hours, and then to get in. I mean, it's freezing cold out here today.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're out working, when you're plowing the snow up, when you hop in your truck, you want it to be comfortable.
Yep, you need the comfort, especially when you're in your truck, 10, 12 hours a day, going job to job.
I mean, this is my rolling office. I mean,
Absolutely.
we're in here 40, 50 hours a week,
mm-hmm.
and you start appreciating things like leather just to keep it clean, the heated seats, the cooled seats, the bright lights if you're doing snow removal you're, you know, at these long hauls.
Even a heated steering wheel kind of makes sense when you realize how cold your hands can get out here.
Especially if you're out, you know, salting walkways or shoveling drives and you get back in the truck.
Something I really appreciate, absolutely.
You know what, Chevy guy, let's take a look over at the 6500 dump body that they got.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
We'll be right back. All right, guys, so we are here at the Chevy booth looking at the 6500 HD Silverado. Is this something you think your business could use?
I think we could both use something like this.
Yeah. This is really, really, really nice.
It's got the two-row seating. You can fit some guys in the back.
Yeah. I've got an F550, and this is definitely a big step up from that.
It's a bigger truck.
It's definitely a beefier truck.
Bigger truck.
So if you look at this truck, it moves away from Chevy's light-duty platform, light-duty being a Class 3 vehicle or below, Class 3 vehicle being a gross vehicle weight rating of 14,000 pounds or less, and it moves you up to a Class 4, 5, or 6, and in some cases even a Class 7 vehicle. And it's all based on the gross vehicle weight rating of the vehicle itself.
Okay.
You look at something like this, this is definitely going to be more in line with like an F650, F750,
correct,
where you move away from the pickup truck body style and you move more towards that medium-duty body style.
Yep.
What's nice about these trucks are though that they're equipping the interior to be much more like a pickup truck, though.
Okay.
So if you sit inside the truck, it's going to emulate that of a half-ton truck or a three-quarter-ton truck.
Yeah.
It's not going to feel a lot different. And believe it or not, that actually makes maneuverability, makes the feeling of being in something not as massive a little bit more manageable.
I have a Chevy 1500, and it feels like I'm in the same truck.
Exactly. And there's nothing wrong with that. A lot of people, you know, a lot of people say, well, you should make them look completely different because they're different types of vehicles. But the reality is, if you can hop out of your Chevy 1500 and hop in this truck, it's a natural progression. You don't feel like you're getting out of a personal vehicle, hopping into a work truck. It kind of makes you more comfortable, more likely for you to enjoy being in this truck.
Right. Yep.
Especially if you have a 25-year-old, you know, young guy that just started with your company, he can feel more comfortable taking this out. Although you really have to trust him, but you can take this truck out and he can already be taking the whole crew, four or five guys, and a trailer can be pulled with this, and this is really cool.
Hop in, check it out.
It's nice, it's comfortable, yeah. Literally, dude, you'll feel like you're sitting in my truck.
So whether or not you're looking at like an F650, 750, or Silverado like this, kind of the story behind it is that they build the platform on straight C-channel frame rails. And because of that, you could take this dump bed off and you could put almost any vocational body on the back of it. It's completely flat. It allows you to not have to worry about going over fuel lines, over your DEF line, things like that. But that's the thing you'd have to realize, though. Moving to a bigger truck, especially if you go with the diesel, you're going to have to worry about other costs, like the higher cost of diesel fuel, as well as the need for DEF, for diesel exhaust fluid.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, and that's part of the reason we haven't upgraded our diesel trucks is to stay away from that, just because I don't feel they've totally worked that system out yet.
Well, you're right. The number one failure point on diesel vehicles nowadays is the emission systems, whether it's your DPF, your diesel particulate filter, your EGRs, which are your exhaust gas recirculation, whether it's the actual system or the sensor. One sensor goes out, your truck's sidelined.
Oh, sure. And that's what we've been told, and that's why I wanted to stay away from it, because especially they work a lot in the winter months for us, and downtime is lethal to us.
Yep. But the other thing to consider, though, is the diesel trucks, as well as the engine, have gotten so much more reliable in a stock form than they've ever been.
Okay.
People can make the claim that the 7.3 was the best power stroke engine ever built. People make the claim that the Cummins is the best diesel engine ever built. And inherently, for longevity, overall lifespan of them, as long as you do the things you need to do to maintain it and keep it on the road, they are very, very reliable engines.
Okay.
However, for the most part, they never produced a lot of power. They were fuel hogs, and at the same time, though, when they had failures, if you didn't address them right away, they could lead to some very expensive issues down the road, mainly tied to fuel injectors and your fuel pump systems and things like that. On these newer diesels, they've really worked out those bugs. The engines themselves are easily 300,000, 400,000-mile engines.
Sure.
You just can't say the same about the emission systems.
Okay.
A DPF system goes out, EGR goes out. You are looking at costly repairs, but they have improved them. They're not as volatile as they were in the past. They've gotten better, and that's something to consider.
Would maintenance be pretty similar with a gas versus diesel, or is it significantly more to maintain a diesel truck?
It depends in what fashion. So, for instance, when you go for a diesel version versus a gas version, you have extended life between oil changes. So, typically on a diesel like this, you can get 15,000 miles before you need to do an oil change. On a gas engine, it's usually recommended every 5,000 to 7,000 miles.
Correct.
So, and for a commercial use, I think they even recommend every 3,000 miles still.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, you need to consider those factors. The cost of doing an oil change in a diesel is marginally more expensive because it requires more oil.
Sure. Yep.
The other thing is you're going to need to do fuel filters a lot more often, and you usually have at least two fuel filters on one of these vehicles.
Yep.
But overall, the performance gains that you get and the long-term fuel economy gains that you get out of diesel can sometimes make it worth it.
So let me ask you this. Let's say, you know, you got a guy that's like me, let's say in landscape. Would you suggest him going into a diesel truck or a gas?
So here's a couple questions.
That's a big one.
Would you want it in a dump body like this? What would you put inside of the back of it that would increase the payload, basically?
Just a pickup hauling like a trailer, like a, you know, 7x14 dump, maybe like a skid steer down the road. You know,
well, skid steer
like
and a 7x4 dump are two completely different beasts from a towing perspective, right? From a weight perspective. Diesel is going to give you better overall towing performance, and it's going to give you better fuel economy numbers while you're towing.
Right.
It's also going to be less wear and tear on the engine during towing. Gas engines are great if you're not doing heavy towing.
Okay.
If you do heavy towing with a gas engine, you put more wear and tear on it, and you decrease its life quicker.
Right. Okay.
So that's kind of the things to think about. Now, the other question ultimately is how heavy is the heaviest trailer you tow? Because I've made segments on that. The biggest segment I have generally is if you are going to be towing anything over 12 to 13,000 pounds, get a diesel.
Okay.
It just makes more sense.
Right.
And that's just the simple answer.
Okay.
If I wanted to go into a more of a complex answer, it ties to everything from gear ratio offerings, from the ability for it to more easily tow it, less wear and tear on the engine itself, longer duty cycles, all these things that factor into that. And more importantly, having that higher capability of expanding it in the future, knowing that if I have a truck that can haul 30,000 pounds and I'm only hauling 15,000 pounds, I'm only putting half of the capability behind what this truck's capable of doing.
Knowing you're going to have that truck for, you know, 6 to 10 years, whatever it might be, and you know your company's going to grow and expand, that might be the better route to go than you're saying.
Absolutely.
Okay.
In my opinion.
That's
if you're going under that 12,000 pound mark, gas engines generally work just fine.
Okay.
So it's like
great.
We find a lot in our business, going bigger is a better long-term decision, whether it's backpack blowers or in this case trucks, because you're going to end up outgrowing that smaller piece of
equipment. Especially in a commercial environment.
Yep.
Do you really want to say that I bought a 3/4 ton truck, and you may even have to deal with this occasionally, is a 3/4 ton truck going to be the best truck for me 3 years from now?
Sure.
Exactly.
Well, I knew my 5-year plan, if you will, that I would not be doing landscaping and other higher end hauling, towing, or putting extra weight and material in that truck. So I'm really glad I listened to him, because he said, go with the gas for my applications. And it was just more confirmation the more people we talked to.
Because you've got other people that are A, gonna handle that workload, and B, already have the equipment.
Totally.
You know, as we say a lot, stay in your lane, right?
Yeah,
yep.
Exactly. You gotta know exactly what you're trying to accomplish.
Yep.
And he's somebody that I learned from in landscaping, so it was really good to hear confirming like the decision. I mean, a year later now that I have my truck, I haven't really regretted not getting a diesel.
Right.
But if I was using it in different applications, I would imagine I would have been regretting it if my company grew.
Yep.
But what I'm growing into, I won't need that diesel. You will.
Right, totally.
More than likely, if you had the same 5-year trajectory.
Yep. And that's kind of where I'm at too. It's like, hey, instead of going to buy a 2500 gasser for 58 grand or whatever it might be, maybe I'm better off getting that next step, getting the diesel and spending an extra 6 to 10 grand, whatever it might be, to get in that option and have it last, you know, 5-10 years out, looking ahead.
I was going to think 6 to 9 years later what you're trying to accomplish.
You know, the other thing to think about too is a lot of people say diesel trucks are only for longer trips, right? So if you're going to do regional work, not necessarily local only work. And that's a hit or miss. Yes, you're going to have less what's called regen cycles, where the vehicle actually regenerates. However, if you look at local city fleets, if you look at vehicles that work around cities every day, your cable company, whoever that might be, you know, they probably have fleets of Ram 5500s, 4500s, F550s, F450s that run every single day
right.
locally, idling all the time, doing all the things they tell you not to do, and they last a long time.
Totally.
Right? Sure. So it's just good to understand that really what it comes down to is just taking care of the truck.
Right.
Doing the things that you know you need to do.
Just regular maintenance.
From a commercial standpoint, probably doing it a little bit more.
Correct.
So I guess
that's the best way.
Question is,
absolutely.
Is this your next pickup?
Yeah, gas or diesel, really. I mean, am I going 3/4 ton or 1 ton?
Is this something you're going to grow into? Because maybe you guys can both go in on 2 and get a better price.
There you go.
It's right? True.
So we can get some leverage in here.
Maybe we can buy this one.
Hey,
and drive it off the floor.
I have bought a truck off the showroom floor, and it did save me a lot of money.
It was a different version, right?
Yeah.
Everybody got that touch. They've
taken it to different trade shows for a couple years, and I was kind of surprised by the price. And the guy's real transparent. He said, my boss said, take it to that show, and we're not bringing it back. So you're selling it on the trade room floor. And,
talks.
Yeah, it did. It did. So there you go, Brandon.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, right.
Let me know.
It's drive it on home.
Yeah. He likes it ruby red.
Yeah, it'll be red. You know, one thing we talked about off camera is important to know. Guys, don't be brand biased anymore. There's no room for it. I mean, like I said, if you are so brand biased, you say, I'm only going to buy Chevy, I'm only going to buy Ford, I'm only going to buy Ram, you're going to miss out on great things that other manufacturers are doing to try to earn your business.
Yep,
and
absolutely.
When I say earn your business, they don't just add things to be cool. They add things in the hope that by adding this great piece of technology, they're going to earn your business. Let me give you an example.
Right. Make your life easier.
This truck right here has a feature. One of the features that I have my F450, the front turning radius. So would you say that in lawn care, landscaping, you run into scenarios where it's hard to maneuver a vehicle?
Totally. Absolutely.
Right? This truck has almost a 50-degree turning angle. To give you a comparison versus your vehicle you currently have now or your truck, you have roughly a 37.5-degree turning angle.
Is that what it is?
Wow. 50-degree turning angle, which means this truck can turn in a circle probably about 6 feet tighter than your truck can.
No kidding.
And part of it is not just maneuverability, but it gives you something that you may not know. If you're going to be doing work on this truck, first of all, when you flip these little hood holds down, flip it up, this hood flips forward,
right.
You can turn this tire out, and you can actually step inside there to work on your engine and do your oil changes.
Okay.
You don't actually have to get a ladder or a step stool to get up on here to do any work on the vehicle. So that wasn't done just to do it. That was done to earn your business. That was done to make life easier on somebody looking to buy a truck like this. So anytime you're shopping for a truck, even though you're a Chevy fan, it makes sense to look at Ram, it makes sense to look at Ford, and it makes sense to look at Chevy.
Okay.
It makes sense to figure out what features they've done to try to earn your business
right.
and make you not only a current customer, but a long-term customer. And then make that same evaluation every time you look at a new vehicle.
Okay.
So guys, you know, definitely like meeting you guys. We're going to spend some more time together.
Sure.
You know, if you have any more questions for me, I'd be happy to answer it. I'm going to be on Brian's channel here a little bit too, and
absolutely.
We'll talk some more. So guys, if you haven't had a chance, subscribe to these gentlemen's channels. Subscribe to mine if you haven't. Give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you again very soon.
Thank you.